guys, this is Haley, and in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys the brand new rabbit cages. As some of you guys know, we've been working really hard to finish these pens for Ebony and Sterling, and I'm so excited to finally show it to you guys. So I'm gonna start off by showing you kind of what the outside of the pen looks like. We just have this wooden wall that goes all the way around the sides. It goes this way, all the way over there. And then we also have a wooden wall that's really tall in the center. On top of the wooden walls, we also have this plexiglass that we've attached. And this is just to add a little bit of extra height to the pens. And it also just kind of gives it a nice finished look. The only place we don't have plexiglass is in the front of Ebony's cage. That's simply because she doesn't know how to jump this high and get out of the pen like Sterling does. So it's just easier to leave it off so that I can reach down and grab things if I need to, and it's just easier to walk in and out this way. But as you can see over here on Sterling's pen, we have plexiglass all the way around, and it's not super clean right now, but that's what it looks like. And on both pens, we have these latches that open and close, and they're just like really cute little barn doors that my dad made, and it's just super adorable looking, and they open and close really nice. So now I'm gonna go ahead and just give you a tour of Ebony's pen. So when you walk in, you see this nice big floor area. I just have this white sheet on it right now, and then this big centerpiece. We're eventually gonna make a permanent stair stepper for her, but for now I'm just using this, which is something I made out of NIC cubes. These are the NIC cubes that I was talking about, so that's kind of what it looks like underneath. Basically, it's just a big square, and then I added another square on top for an additional step. So she can jump up here and then jump onto here. And then there's a nice little door right here for her to go inside of. Then she can just lift up right here if she wants, and that's how she gets into another little hidey house. Ebony is a very territorial rabbit. She's very territorial over her cage, so normally I wouldn't be walking into her cage area when she is in here. But for the purpose of this cage tour, I am going to be doing that, but I'm gonna be respecting her privacy as much as possible. So straight ahead, we have her hay box, which is overlooking the two litter boxes. And these are just hay boxes that my dad has made for Ebony and Sterling. I'm actually going to be selling these on my Etsy shop very, very soon. So if you guys want one of these hay boxes, be sure to keep an eye out on my social media and on my Etsy store. The Etsy store will be linked in the iCard up above. And the shelf does have this wire grid up just to kind of add a protective layer. And this hook here hooks it onto the hay box so that it's nice and sturdy. And then over here in the middle, we have a dog leash clip that connects these two together. So if I unclip it all, this actually folds all the way down so that I can have it nice and open and clean the cages. But I'm not gonna do that right now because I don't really wanna bother Ebony, but that is what happens when I clean her pen. So after the litter boxes, we have this long hidey house, which is also made out of NIC cubes. And there's little Ebony. She's so adorable. She's like, hey, what you doing? I have a Snugabun in there right on that entrance, and then she can walk around. There's an entrance here, and then there's also an entrance right over here where you can see her little nose peeking out. And then I have a couple of toys. This is just a grass mat. That's just a little throwing toy and another wire ball. Then over here we have her veggies, which she didn't finish them all. She has this weird thing where she doesn't finish all her morning veggies, but she normally finishes her nighttime veggies. Hi, baby girl, what you looking at? And then right over in the corner here, we have her water dish. These are some new water dishes that I got, and I think they're super cute. So I just kind of want to give an overall look at this cage so that you can really grasp where everything is. And I will mention that down under here, you can see some more wire grids. That's simply because we do have to add an extra board here, just because Sterling and Ebony share a wall, meaning like they can't access each other because there's a wall between them, but they can like sense that each other are there. And so she's been like scratching at the wall a lot. So we're gonna add a nice thick board in front of there just so that you know, if she starts chewing on the wood, it's just a nice thick board that she's chewing on, and she'll never, you know, chew all the way through or anything. So for right now, I just have some wire grids there, and that's really kept her from chewing anymore. And I guess this mat is also gonna help her chew on something else. And then this might look a little funny to some people, so I'm gonna explain what this is for. Like I mentioned earlier in the video, Ebony is extremely cage aggressive and cage territorial. So basically when a rabbit is cage territorial, they will lunge and grunt at you if you stick your hand in their cage. This is simply a natural response for them. They're just protecting their territory. They don't want any danger to come in. But this can become a problem when you're trying to feed your rabbit and give your rabbit water and stuff like that. So we've created this new system that my vet actually recommended I do with her. And so far it has worked really well, but I want to give it a couple of months just, you know, before I say for sure how well it's working. But simply what we do is this board is removable. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you how this board works real quick. Basically what it does is I can pull it out of the slot and move it to the far slot right in the back. What this does is it allows me to access her veggies and her water without her being able to see me or get at me. As you can see from the footage, she is actually right here as I'm doing this, and there is no aggressive lunging, there is no growling, there is no biting. It's a much calmer experience. She's a lot more calm, I'm a lot more calm, and it lets feeding and giving water so much easier. So this system is really nice so far for Ebony and me, just with her personal needs, with her territorialness and aggression. So that's basically it for Ebony's pen. I love how it looks, and she is loving it too. She loves her shelves so much. She's always hiding in her little hidey house, and she does come down once in a while onto the floor, like for playtime and stuff, but otherwise she just loves being up on her shelf. Now I'm gonna go ahead and show you Sterling's side of the pen. It is a little bit darker over here just because of where the light is positioned on the ceiling, but we do plan to add an extra light over the top of his pen. So as I mentioned before, he does have that plexiglass all the way up on top of his door, and I just open it with the latch, and you can walk right in. So his floor area is pretty bare as well. He mainly just eats his veggies down here. It's super easy for me to open the door and just grab his veggie plate. And then his water is right there, and Milo just got in the pen. Milo! So as I was saying, his water dish is there, and then his ramp is right there. Otherwise, there's really nothing else on his cage floor, except for his veggie plate, of course. So Sterling loves his ramp and his shelves. As you can see, the blanket is a little bit messed up, but I'll fix that in a second. But his ramp just leads all the way up to his shelf right here. And he basically has the same shelf system as Ebony. It's just kind of reversed, so kind of like the shelf is on the opposite side as hers is. I will show you an example of how these cage bars drop down for easy cleaning. So you just unlock the clip right here, and once you unlock it, this one just swings all the way down, and then this one comes down also. So this is kind of just what it looks like without the cage bars on top of it. It's super easy to clean this way. This one doesn't come all the way down just because it kind of hits the ramp. We haven't decided what we're gonna do about this. We're not sure if we're gonna just like cut a little piece of this off so that it can go all the way down, or if we're gonna use a different type of ramp. But it works completely fine. I can access the cage super easy. It's literally so easy to get in there. So right here we have Sterling. He's a little bit nervous because normally the only time I enter his pen is if, you know, something's up or if I have to pick him up for some odd reason. But I tend to respect my rabbit's areas. Even if he doesn't struggle with cage aggression, I just simply think it's good for a rabbit to have their own space and not to invade their space too much. So he's kind of like, what are you doing in my pen? But he's not aggressive or territorial whatsoever. Underneath this fleece, I have this in Ebony's cage as well, but I didn't show you. I do have these memory foam mats. They're basically bath mats. and I just put fleece on top just to make sure it's nice and squishy for them and on their feet. And I'll mention that the cage floor of this is puzzle mats. These are what puzzle mats look like without any fleece on top. Then he has this plastic Heidi house. They no longer sell these anymore. I always get questions on where I buy them, but they no longer sell it. I got it at Bed Bath & Beyond years ago, and I love it. All the bunnies love it. So there's three entrances in it, but one of them's facing the wall right now. So he can hop through there, and then this is a willow teepee. This is from Binky Bunny. As you can see, he's chewed quite a bit of it, but actually hasn't destroyed it yet, which is good because he still likes to sleep in it. And over here we have his litter boxes and his hay box. Again, this is a hay box that my dad made. I'll be selling them on my Etsy shop super soon, so go ahead and hit that button in the iCard and it will take you to my Etsy shop. So that is basically it for the bunny's new pens. I really hope you enjoy them. It's taken us a lot of work and a lot of planning to get here, but I love how they've turned out. Everyone give a huge thank you to my dad because he's actually the one who did basically everything for these pens and the design. I also want to mention that if you become a part of my Patreon, you will get early access to things like this. I've showed everyone on my Patreon the pictures of the cages. I also did a live stream of a tour of Ebony's cage. They've also seen Lulu's new cage, which is upstairs in my office. So if you guys want early access to special things like this before I'm able to film a proper cage tour, go ahead and join my Patreon. The link will be in the iCard, also in the link down below. Patreon is just a place where you can support content creation that you love, and it's a place where you can connect and get more access to me and talk to me easier. And I'll say that my live streams for Patreon have been so much fun, and I love everyone who is able to come to them. That's basically it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you love the new pens. I will have Lulu's cage tour out very, very soon, so be sure to keep an eye out for that. And that's basically it. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you guys very soon on a new video. Bye!